Could these people of many nations become a part of the American way of life?
We have the worst immigration laws in the entire world.
We can do this.
This needs to get done.
We will not leave here without the Dream Act.
We're not bargaining chips. Those dreamers were a separate
issue. Actually, you are.
The United States will not be a migrant camp.
We did not invite you here. You cannot stay here.
The migrant crisis has brought to power a hardline coalition in Rome and led to a more fragile one in Germany.
More and more illegals, criminals coming in. The U.S. should be careful too. Better build your wall to Mexico, he says.
President Donald Trump, we've heard, has called Africa
President said, why are we having people from all these shithole countries come here? Wondering whether more people could come from Norway. Now, lawmakers from both parties worry the president's remarks could jeopardize talks to reform the nation's immigration system.
A path to citizenship for 1.8 million illegal immigrants.
Why would you start with 1.8 million?
This is exactly opposite what Trump said he was going
to
do.
Border security does have to be part of this process.
Senators failed to advance a bipartisan bill.
The debate lasted about an hour, and not one of the four proposals to protect DACA recipients got enough votes.
DACA recipients have been treated extremely badly by the Democrats.
Troops are on the move, headed to the U.S.-Mexico border.
The National Guard is playing a complementary role to aid and support what the Border Patrol is doing.
The order comes as a caravan of Central American migrants seeking asylum moves closer to the United States through Mexico.
Until we can have a wall and proper security, we're going to be guarding our border with the military.
The growing numbers of forced family separations along the southern U.S. border. Nearly 2,000 children were separated from their guardians.
Mr. President, don't you have kids?
Are you intending for parents to be separated from their children? Are you intending to send a message?
I find that offensive. No.
Hopefully people will get the message and come through the border at the port of entry.
This new zero tolerance policy, is it humane? I think it's the law. I noticed the long pause. You know, it's unfair to the men and women of ICE to make them engage in an inhumane policy.
The parents of these illegal alien children need to make better decisions. Like I hope I'm making the right decisions for my children, they need to do the same.
President Trump caves. In a stunning about-face, the president, in a matter of hours, went from defending the separation of children from their parents to signing an executive order that stops the exact same policy.
The U.S. government faces a court-ordered deadline today. The Trump administration has already admitted that roughly 914 parents will not be reunited with their children.
More than 700 children have still not been reunited.
3 months later, 245 children are still in U.S. custody. The Supreme Court has upheld the president's right to enact this travel ban.
Refugees are welcome here.
You can certainly empathize with them, but I think the safety of Americans would probably trump the inconvenience of a few.
The Lebanese government is increasingly eager for the more than 1 million Syrian refugees here to go home.
We can't go back, ever, Mustafa al-Ibadi says. He doesn't trust the Assad regime.
There's a 90% chance I'll be thrown in prison, he says. What good does that do me? It's better to stay here.
How can you throw away a whole generation of people that you invited to come here?
Barbara is part of what's known as the Windrush Generation, a wave of migrants from the Caribbean encouraged to come rebuild the UK after World War II. They were told they could stay for the rest of their lives. Later, the government would begin to demand documentation to prove their right to stay.
Tourists taking a Zumba class. In the background, the Maersk cargo ship carrying rescued migrants now stranded off the coast of Sicily.
Italy's newly installed government decided to close Italian ports to the NGO rescue ship. It was a strong-arm move on the part of the Interior Minister Matteo Salvini, who wants other European countries to help Italy deal with the influx of migrants.
A 35-year-old German man was killed, stabbed to death. Police arrested a Syrian and Iraqi. That triggered calls on social media to take to the street.
The Venezuelan migration crisis is quickly escalating.
This year alone, more than 423,000 Venezuelan migrants are fleeing the economic and humanitarian crisis in their homeland.
Mass exodus is increasing tensions in countries like Peru, Ecuador, Brazil, and Colombia.
This is how Central American migrants cross the border. You can't really see any migration authorities or the military or police.
They throw rocks like they did at the Mexico military and police. I say, consider it a rifle.
The president is on a midterm media blitz, but he's doing so by actually lying and spreading some misinformation that the migrant caravan is full of criminals and unknown Middle Easterners.
There's no proof of anything, but they could very well be.
Vean, la multitud ya se encuentra mucho más gente de la que estamos viendo arriba.
Many from that migrant caravan have stormed the U.S. border yesterday.
They deployed tear gas to protect themselves and to protect the border.
People who say, you know, these people are lawbreakers and this and this and that. In our eyes, what we did was necessary for us to survive.
I'm confident that the contributions that I and other immigrants make to America, it's going to eventually prevail.
Republicans and Democrats alike know that we've got to lead on immigration reform.
We've got to fix U.S. laws.
This must be our number one priority.
Great frustration is many of the issues that we deal with right now on immigration are a direct result of Congress. We don't ever seem to resolve the issue. We talk about it.